Okay, there goes an ambulance. This is Julian Reyes live in Austin, Texas. It is 1:30 and there has been a shooting. An Austin police officer has been shot and an Austin police officer has shot in return. You don't really need people's opinions, you need video. That's why I'm here. I'm late as usual, but I'm here. It's more than I can say for a lot of y'all. Y'all out there filming? Y'all want to know anything that's going on? Or are you just going to sit back and wait for it to happen to you or your family like it did to me? Yeah. Learn from my lesson. Don't wait. I was just talking. Now I'm taking action. So basically, here's REI and book people. As you can see, the majority of people here are low melanin content on their skin, and they have higher bank accounts in general. Now that's a generality. Not everybody can be individually selected in a conversation, but you can talk about groups in general and demographics in general. That's what the point of statistics and everything.
Peaceful streets, undercover ones, and film police, right?
Yep.
Yeah. It's a mob boss.
So the Austin Police Association has gang stalked a lot of people. They're ex-cops, or actually Cassiday's a current corporal. Can't remember his first name. Corporal Cassiday. And I've seen him out on the beat on 6th Street. I've also seen him stalk the Peaceful Streets groups and try to infiltrate filmers. He's a dirty cop. It's really nice that he's the one in charge of the contract that basically got the city by the balls. And everybody that gets shot, every cop that commits a crime, anything, is all going to be covered up because of the APA's contract and their inability to have any kind of a subpoena power or witness gathering, information gathering, independent investigations. They control it all internally. They actually tamper with evidence and many others. There's just all sorts of stuff that the Police Association, the Public Information Office, and all these people are going to talk to the media. They're all going to give them lies. They're getting their story together now. That's why they're taking so long, and they won't release any kind of video, which is proof. So all these people are going to repeat lies, and you're going to only get independent sources from independent photojournalists like me. Unfortunately, that's just the way it goes. There's got to be more ethics in journalism than what we see today. Way more. When I was at Baylor taking journalism class, ethics was just every other word. And now there's just no truth. Awesome, guys. How's it going? See, the cop shot my dog, Shinerbach, and this is my dog replacement. I'm in federal court. I'm the only one that takes anybody to court around here, apparently. Michael Paxton been taking court. Thanks a lot, guys. You got beautiful dogs.
Thank you.
prior to contacting the subject, and at one point, the subject started coming back eastbound on West 5th, near to West Avenue. The security officer ended up indicating somebody to call 911, and he subsequently went into foot pursuit of the white male suspect, who in fact had broken into vehicles in the parking lot of this complex. The foot pursuit proceeded up here on West Avenue. When our officer turned the corner, any marked black and white police car and patrol officer sees the security guard chasing the suspect. The officer, a little after 11 o'clock in the morning, puts out that he has one chasing someone, requests backup. The suspect runs into the parking lot of Frank and Angie's, where the security guard knocks him to the ground. The suspect gets back up, security guard knocks him to the ground again, and at this time, this is all on video, our officer pulls in, gets out of the car, and starts trying to control the suspect. Suspect is on the ground struggling with our officer. You can actually see our officers giving commands, trying to gain compliance. The suspect is not complying with the officer's commands. At which point, the officer actually put out an additional call asking for the police to step up to examine the bad suspect. The security guard then, at the request of the officer, assisted the officer, came to the officer's aid, was assisting the officer, and that suspect suddenly, without any warning, turned, took out a semi-automatic pistol, fired one shot at our officer. The gunshot hit our officer below the vest, in the lower right abdomen. The officer immediately turned fire, striking the suspect, at which point folks, I believe, in this building here started calling, other folks to call 911, saying that an officer had been shooting at one of the calls, stating that an officer had been shot. Officer assistance call came out, another officer arrived on scene, first officer arrived on scene, had a gun, and the suspect stands still.
Texas.
credibility of an officer, but this witness was provided some statements in a very trying circumstances. They're extremely, extremely accurate, speaks volumes as to his professionalism. And as to our officer, who was able to not, after being shot, reacted so quickly, professionally, and in the threat before that, this person and anybody else. So with that, the investigation will be ongoing.
Physical action to try to
Chief. Chief, does this mean that if a wealthy person, in the West End here had done the same thing, would he have also been, he or she also been shot?
You know what? I think that's a ridiculous question.
Answer is yes. Answer is yes. That would have happened to Jerry Jones when he didn't pull over for Dallas police if they acted like this. I like it when the chief can't answer my questions. Neither can the director of the OPM. Liars usually can't. They need time to come up with their lies. So that's the difference between media and independent media right there. Tough questions or give us a standard answer. So chief says it's a ridiculous question if a rich person had not given their hands up and it had been armed, which we have 50 guns to one person here in Texas, so every rich person has a stockpile. Trust me, I don't have any guns. Somebody's got my 50. So it's not a ridiculous question, and when it happens, I'll post this video again. And you guys can eat those words, chief, and all the rest of you. Here's the Whole Foods Market. Park on the roof. Security guard up there. You could get gunned down here too. Anywhere there's a security guard that's willing to like escalate you, yeah. Really, security guards aren't supposed to tackle people under the law. They're not supposed to touch people under the law unless they're being attacked. I couldn't really hear the whole story there. It'll be in the media. Hopefully they'll cover it because I don't have a boom mic. If you want me to have a boom mic, you're going to have to invest in me because I don't have money for no boom mic. I barely stay alive. I spend so much time doing volunteer activism that I actually neglect a lot of my work, and my boss wants me to do more work and do activism at the same time. So we'll see what happens. Well, there's a security guard or a cell phone, you can get murdered. Once APD arrives, they have seconds to respond and they consider everybody a threat. They escalated that guy on the ground. That's why he's shot. You know what? Don't escalate people on the ground. Namaste, y'all. Be safe. Film the police.